Hello students, today we discuss the continuation of population and organisms. In this population interdependence as well as population interactions, simply population interactions. One among the other subtopic in 13.2, population interactions. Before that one, population interdependence also is there. From one organism to another organism, it must interdepend, related to food, related to space, for all remaining different activities and all. It must require interdependence and all. So without dependent, even though plant we consider as autotrophs, even though it depend upon light, it depend upon soil, depend upon water. So every organism, it must interdependent with the other organism, related to by gathering of food, by taking of food, by mating purpose, or various different activities. Each and every organism, it must interdependent. Along with these one, there must be different types of relationships also, they must be maintained. So this last subtopic in this chapter, it is most important in exam point of view. In this one, compulsory 1 bit or 2 bits they must pass in exam point of view. Observe carefully. Here, what type of relationships are there? Among the population, there are 3 different types of relationships are present. One is the positive relationship, then negative relation, that means negative interaction, then neutral interaction. One is the positive interaction. Name itself represents, what is it by positive interaction? Between the two organisms, the organisms are both are beneficial. The interaction between two organisms, in the two organisms, both are beneficial. Such type of interaction we call as positive interaction. That means here two organisms are participated, that interaction they denotes if it is benefited, beneficial of the organism, it represents or it denotes the symbol, the symbolic representation, that is plus one. Whenever the symbol, if it represents as a minus and all, that specific organism, they become as this one, loss and all, they become as harmful nature and all. That is, in negative interaction, positive interaction, or either plus zero. Both organisms are benefited. Here, among the two organisms, one organism is benefited, another organism neither benefited nor harmful one. That is, that symbolic representation zero, neither benefit nor harmful. Similarly, negative interaction. One among the organism benefited, another organism harmful effect. That is plus as well as minus, or it is also represent minus zero. Minus zero. Here one is the harmful effect, another one neither harmful nor benefited. Another interaction. Minus, minus, both organisms are harmful effect. Normally, this type of interaction, normally we observe into the competition. This type of interaction, normally we observe into the mensalism. This type of interaction, parasitism, predation. This type of interaction, mutualism, as well as proto-cooperation. This type of one, commensalism as well as scavengers. So different types of these aspects are present. Then what is the symbolic representation in that neutral interaction and all? Here, neutral interaction. Both organisms neither benefited nor harmful nature in one specific habitat. Different types of these species are present. Among these species, there is no neither benefit nor harmful. There is no any specific competition among themselves. Such type of interaction based on space, based on mating, based on food material, there is no interaction. Such type of in a specific habitat between that particular organisms, we call it as different types of organism. That is neutral interaction and all. It represents very simple. First we discuss about neutral interaction only. Where we observe that neutral interaction and all, normally we observe in a rabbit, rat and shrew. Any one habitat, any one specific habitat, in that specific habitat, they live different types of these species like a rabbit, rat as well as shrew. Both are different types of the mammals and all. Different types of mammals. Then rabbit, what it eats rabbit? Rabbit eats grass. What it takes the rat and all? Rat, it must take either seeds as well as fruits and all. Or both. But majorly, it must take seeds. Sometimes it takes fruits also. Both seeds as well as fruits and all. Shrew, it takes or it eats only insects and all. Like that, various different types of food methods, food constituents are present. That's why there is no competition. No one organism between rabbit and rat, there is no interaction in any aspects and all. Then related to birds, frugivorous as well as related insectivorous, in one plant, two birds are living. These two birds, their food habits are totally different and all. In what type of totally different their food habits and all? Related to birds, frugivore, insectivore. In one particular habit, two different types of the birds are present. That is the frugivore, the bird which takes fruits, the bird which takes insects and all. Different food habits are present. Because of different food habits, automatically there is no competition. So neither benefit nor harmful effect. Here also, neutral interaction must present in frugivorous as well as insectivorous birds and all. Sometimes this type of relation also they may ask and all. They give any one specific concept. Based on the concept, you identify what type of relation, what type of interaction between the organisms, among the organisms and all. Here, in this, these are the examples related to neutral interaction and all. Then, related to negative interaction. So, what type of interaction normally we observe the negative interaction? How many different types are present in negative interaction? In negative interaction, predation. It is present. Predation as well as parasitism, commensalism, commensalism as well as competition. This specific one, it represents negative interaction between the organism. Just as I said, among these or between the two specific organisms, one among the organism benefited, another organism with harmful effect and all. In this one, in predation parasitism, what type of sign it represent? One among the it represent this one plus, that means predator. Here there are two organisms are involved under. One among the beneficial organism it represent predator. That organism benefited. It denotes plus symbol. Similarly, negative. The organism which harmful effect. The organism which harmful effect. That it represent prey and all. So plus as well as minus symbol it represent and all. Similarly, parasitism. Parasitism also plus, that is parasite. Similarly, minus the place where it lives, the place where it collect, the place where it infect, the place where it degenerate, then where it occupies, that is it must harmful effect, that is the host, whatever it may be. Then amensalism. In that amensalism, one among the organism harmful, that is another one zero, neither harmful nor benefited. In this one, amensal related to neither benefit nor harmful and all. Amensal related to zero, neither benefit nor harmful. This amensal, it releases a specific chemicals and all. These chemicals that represent, that is related to allochemics. It releases allochemics and all. That's why it is regarded as allopathy. It represents amensalism. Normally it represents allopathy because of it secretes specific chemicals, that is allo. This one neither benefit nor harmful, amensal. Then whatever the host, this represents as the host and all. The host, it is wherever it secretes, wherever it releases the specific organism, that harmful effect and all. That is minus as well as zero. Because of releasing, that is important. What is the specific chemical secreted? The amensal and all. Allochemics. That's why it is called as allelopathy. Then competition. Here also two types of competition is present. Either intra or inter. Within the same species, if specific source of common food material. So within the same species with the common food material, then the competition becomes very severe and all. Related to within, not only within the same species, but also different types of species. If it lives one particular habitat, there also competition is present. That is interspecific interaction. Different types of species which lives together, there also competition is present in different aspects and all. Either intra or inter, there it is present. Minus as well as minus interaction. In that both are harmful, no one benefited and all. That is related to this one. Among this one, in exam point of view, which among these, that negative interaction act as a critical role takes place, biotic controlling method and all, biocontrol method. Which among these one, it act as a very important role, that biocontrolling method and all. Then your answer, they give all these options. What is your answer? Predation. Predation act as an important role to control. That means biotic control and all. It act as a biological controlling agents and all. It act as biological controlling agents and all. So this predation, related to predation, examples of predation, in that predation, that examples related to land snake, Land snake eats to the rat. Here land snake act as a predator, snake act, that is a rat, act as this one, prey and all. Here prey will be harmful effect, it is the benefited and all. This is the predator, this is the prey and all. Related to frogs as well as insects. Owl. Owl also rat and dog. Owl, rat, as well as sea snake. It eats the eggs. It eats the eggs and dog. Then it acts as the trichoderma or trichomatis. This organism, it must be controlled or it must take or related to ticks and all. Or instead of this one, their consideration, their related to its consideration, different types of this particular biological controlling method. How, what type of organism, biological controlling method related to predation and all. Let's suppose locust. Locust organism, it acts as very harmful effect in a specific crop plants and all. It may be get maximum reduction to reduce the production of the croplands and all, especially in this Mauritius area. In this Mauritius area, if it introduce one specific the particular bone and all, minor in Mauritius area to control the population of locust, that means here mina act as a predator, locust act as a prey. Like predation, prey, to control the biological control term. Related to Opuntia also in Australia, it act as a major weed plant to control the normal crop plants in the specific area. How to control, how to avoid such type of Opuntia. These plants under Cactoblastis. By in Australia, Cactoblastis moth, if it introduced Cactoblastis moth. So in exam point of view, Cactoblastis, Opuntia, what type of interaction? So what type of interaction normally we observe Opuntia as well as Cactoblastis, they give different options and all. Then you write that is a predation, but it must be helps in biological controlling and all. By introduction of the moth, it is a predator, it acts as prey and all. Similarly, it is also present the larva of mosquito. How to control larva of the mosquito? By introduce one type of the fishes, that is insectivorous fish and all. What is the name of the fish? That is Gambusia. By introduction of the Gambusia, then it kills, then it control the maximum population of larva of mosquitoes which are present in that aquatic nature and all, in that water content and all. There it maximum controlling related to these particular aspects and all. Similarly, aphids also, it must be lost maximum and all. It control by introduction of lady bird beetle. It controls lady bird beetles and all. Lady bird beetle. So, like this, it acts as major role, biological control method related to predation. Then, what about parasitism. So these parasites, there are different types of adaptation to adjust as well as to suit as well as to accommodate to insected, to infected various organisms, various hosts and all. That is holdfast as well as suckers, such type of as well as pins or spines, many different types of adaptations it must take and all. It must be adjustable, it must be adapted to adjust according to environmental condition, according to type of the host and all. So different types of adaptations required various types of the parasite. It depends upon the type of parasite and all. Why? Because some of the parasite it lives, but it may be causes disease rather than predation and all. Predation it kills at a time or slowly and all. But here related to it must be kills maximum number of the specific organisms and all. Maximum number of specific organisms. So that's why parasite act as a vital role, but different types of parasites present. So before that one more concept you must learn. Suppose herbivores, what type of interaction present in herbivores and all? Herbivore also one type of the predation. Why? Because the herbivores, either cow, sheep, goat, deer, whatever it may be, ox, it eats the grass material. Grass is a living one. This is related to it. In this one, cow act as predator, then grass act as prey and all. But due to the food chain and all, that is important, very most important. Due to food chain as well as different type of the trophic levels. Next chapter we discuss that one, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, like this one. Various type of trophic levels and all. Wherever in food chain, the predator sometimes act as a prey and all. For example, frog. If it eats insects, it acts as a predator. Suppose snake, if it eats to the frog, then the frog acts as a prey and all. That's very simple. So predator in a food chain, sometimes it acts as this one, prey and all. So in statement level of questions, that is important and all. Now related to that different types of these parasites, some of the parasites lives into the external body surface and all. What type of the parasites lives into the external body surface? Such type of parasites we call as ectoparasites. Outer surface of the body, either skin, if it is animals and all, if it is any plants and all, it lives on the surface of the morphological parts and all, either leaf, either stem, either root, whatever. So morphological, external features, the parasite, it must be used under. These ectoparasites, example, like mites, as well as locust or lice, it will be present, lice. Aphids, it will be present under. So these related to ectoparasitic organisms and all. Then endoparasites, it lives related to internal body parts and all. Internal body parts, that means it lives into the body fluids. What type of the parasite which lives into the body fluids and all? Trypanosoma, that means Trypanosoma gambiens, it lives into the body fluids and all. Then related to intracellular fluids and all, or some of these organisms lives into the intracellular part and all. That is Plasmodium. Normally it lives inside the RBC, red blood cells and all. Then some of lives inside the tissues and all, inside the tissue parts and all. So some of the organism which lives into the inside the tissue parts. So what type of organism normally it lives into the inside the tissue parts and the tissue parts of that specific organisms, that is related to trichomonas or trichophytes and all. These trichophytes which are present inside the tissues, that is related to endoparasitic nature and all. Apart from this one, some of the organisms are temporary, some of temporary parasites. What type of organisms related to temporary parasites and all? In temporary parasites related to that is female mosquito. Female mosquito as well as bed bugs as well as leeches. Here also you must write either leech also it becomes ectoparasite. Ectoparasite is common. Both lice as well as leech, it represent both ecto as well as temporary parasite and all. Then which represent permanent parasite and all? Permanent parasite, that is it represent Ascaris as well as Entamoeba. Ascaris, Entamoeba represent permanent parasites and all. Related to some of these one, holoparasite. That means it acts as complete parasites and all. Rafflesia, Cascuta. Rafflesia as well as Cascuta represent holoparasite. Hemiparasite. Some of the organisms, Viscum as well as Loranthus. It represents, that means hemi or a semi-parasite. Half of it depends upon, half of it completely individual under. So 50% independently, rest of 50% depends upon the rest of wherever it must be present, wherever it must be lives under. Then semi-parasite, then brooding parasite. Some of these animals, especially birds, especially quail, it never construct or prepare in its own nest and all. Actually, crow prepare their nest. It lays eggs and all. Then, in this quail, it laying eggs inside the crow nest and all. That means, quail, it laying eggs in crow nest, inside the crow nest, but it mimic, it is similar from one to another organism. Crow eggs as well as quail egg, both are similar, but unable to identify the crow and all, it must hatching and comes out to the young ones and all. So that is brooding, that is also one type of brooding parasitism. Unable to provide the energy, unable to provide the temperature. The crow only, it must provide energy in the form of temperature. After hatching, it comes out to the specific young ones and all. So like that, brooding parasitism, many times they ask an exam point of view, what is the interaction between quail as well as crow? Then you write the option is the brooding parasitism. So what type of interaction between tiger as well as deer and all, then you write the option that is the predation. But for escaping such type of the predation and all, there are also various methods they must implemented and all. What type of various methods are implemented to escape from predation and all, it is also very important. Like mimicry, mimic as well as camouflage. So either mimic, camouflage, act as the chief role to escape from predation. As well as it is also one among the best example related to competition also, to escape from their competition. Or similarly, predation also. So camouflage, mimic, to escape, especially originally it is the predation and all. Then related to in this parasitism, then what is it by here? Tissue that means that is trichomes or trichomonas or trichomatis, that is it represented and all. Then related to amensalism, what it represents, amensalism. Minus as well as zero, it indicates this one. Amensalism. Amensalism, just now I said, it secretes amensal, secret a specific allochemicals. It interfere or it react in that specific host. Based on that one among these one, neither benefit nor harmful. Another one, automatically it is harmful effect and all. In this best example related to amensalism, antibiotics. Any antibiotic, for example, penicillin. Here they have given example penicillin, either streptomycin, chloromycin, erythromycin, tetramycin, any type of the antibiotic, whatever they give in exam point of view. Any antibiotic, it acts as commensal, that means amensal. This, it secretes specific chemicals, then to secretes to reduce or to interfere or to suppress the growth or to reduce the growth of the opposite type of the parasitic nature of organism. Suppose penicillin, it reduce or it suppress or it inhibit the growth of Streptococcus bacteria. So this penicillin, it suppress or inhibit the growth of this one Streptococcus bacteria. Here may not be affected, here see, here minus, it acts as zero and all. Then related to some other organisms also act as amensalism nature also is present and all. Some of the smoother crops, some of these smoother crops, it inhibit the growth of the weed plants. What type of these smoother crops? If it develops such type of smoother crops in normal crop plants, it reduce or it inhibit the rest of these weed plants and all. So in that related to smoother crops are like the barley crops, sorghum, sunflower, asimum. These smoother crops inhibit or suppress the surrounding of the any type of the weed plants and all. So it acts as amensal. So this particular organism neither benefit nor harmful, but it harmful effect the respectable of the specific type of any type of weed plants and all. Then convolvulus. It controls weed plants and all, especially specific weed plants. It controls or suppress weed plants and all related to convolvulus. Then related to trichoderma, this specific organism, it suppress the specific growth of the aspergillus. So to check the aspergillus growth and all, to check the aspergillus. Aspergillus may causes different types of diseases. That's why without spreading, it control, it bind, it inhibit or it checks which one, trichoderma organism. Then related to another very important related to one among these wood plant, that is oak plant, silver oak plant. Silver oak plant, it acts as autopathy. Silver oak plant, it acts as autopathy. What is the meaning of autopathy? It inhibits in its own seed. In its own seed growth and all. Does not allowing. So, does not allowing. That scientific name, Grevillea. The silver oak plant scientific name Grevillea, it inhibit to the suppressing growth of the, or the suppressing germinating of in its own seeds and all. That is required as autopathy. Autopathy and all. So that is different types of that amensalism, various types of amensalism, these organisms and all. Then rest of this one related to, it is also present. Then another competition, what is the competition related to either intra as well as inter? There are different types of this competition is present. Intra competition among the same species, the competition among the same species, it represent or it indicates as this one, it represent or indicates intra competition among the same species. That is, we call as intra competition among the same species, if it is present, it represents or indicates as this one, intras, but among these one, suppose the herd of cows within the same, that means all these similar organism, it compete with a similar resource, of the things and all, whether related to space, related to food, related to mating. So what type of resource? This organism, it must compete either space, either food, either mating. In a specific resource among the space, there is a severe competition. Any type of same organisms and all. Related to interspecific. Even interspecific also there is a competition. Related to space, related to availability of food, as well as gathering of this, that mating and all. Then searching of that cooperation, interdependence and all. In this interspecific competition also it must be present and all. But this interspecific competition, different species, the gathering of or group of organism, different organisms. Among the different species. But it is more competition, where it represents as this one, more competition and all, whenever different species and all. For example, according to Gauss principle, what they said, Gauss principle, no two organisms may not live in one particular niche and all. So, one specific organism, it represents, that means the functional role of the organism in that habitat. It represents as this one, that biological niche and all. Here, a specific organism, specific niche is present, N-I-C-H-E. Suppose two organisms, two different organisms present according to Gauss. Two different organisms present within the same niche and all. So, one among these two organisms are eliminated. One among the two organisms are eliminated. Because of no two organisms may not be survivor, may not be cooperated within the specific that habitat and all. For example, Paramecium aurelia, Paramecium caudatum, both are present within the same habitat, within the same culture, then which type of organisms are, it must be survival, which are, which among these one eliminated, and here Paramecium aurelia, it must survive well. The completely eliminated Paramecium caudatum, completely eliminated because of different species, but within the same niche, unable to this one. Similarly, Cornell's scientist also explained the same manner. The barnacles related to, apart from this one, in this Balanus, one among the organism, either larger or smaller and all. In this Balanus, it must extincted or related to, it must separated, or this in Balanus organisms separated, it must separated to the Chthamalus organism. Balanus organisms, it to eliminate Chthamalus organisms, according to Cornell's principle, between two organisms different types of species are present. If it is, one is the larger, bigger, stronger, another one is the weaker, smaller, thinner one, automatically according to Darwin's principle, the weaker, thinner eliminated in that competition. So here Balanus related to very stronger, very larger when you compare to the Chthamalus, and that's why these particular organisms are aquatic organism. So because of the competition, based on the food, based on the shelter, based on the space, or any different aspects under, so Balanus organisms more survival. Which organism between these two, it must eliminated because of the morphological, it must, because of the same niche, because of two different species, unable to survive maximum period of time. Whomever stronger, that organism, it must present. Rest of the organism, automatically it must be eliminated and all. Okay? So remaining part, we discuss in next class.